In this video, we will be making a minimalist phone mockup from your phone using a free app called PixelLab. To keep things simple, we will first download a reference image from DuckDuckGo. Not Google Images, because it no longer lets you download the images in full resolution. So just type in your phone model you want to create the mockup of and download the image from DuckDuckGo. And yes, I am also using Microsoft Edge. Fight. I would recommend finding a rendered image instead of a photograph, like this Galaxy S20 mockup for example. This is what we will be using for this tutorial, link to it will be in the description below. In PixelLab, let's first get rid of our new text and this vomit of a background and make it a solid white. Let us now import our reference image that we downloaded from our gallery. Crop it and if needed, then press OK. We will enable guides and snap to guides, which is this magnet icon, and place our reference image exactly in the center. You can hide the guides when you're done. We will lock this layer so we don't accidentally move it around. First, we will make the outermost body of the phone. So create a new shape and precisely place it around the edges. You can decrease the shape opacity to see under it. And you can also zoom in to make it precise. Round those edges like it's another day on Dribbble. When it comes to color, you can make it however you want. I want to keep it as close to the reference image as possible, so I will select a color from our reference image. I think this blue will do just fine. Bring your opacity back to 100 when you're done, then tap save. Open layers panel and duplicate this shape. We will lock our previous shape so we don't move it by accident. We will be locking every layer we are done working with. Turn on guides again and place it in the middle. Go to shape edit menu and pull in these edges very slightly. Keep in mind that this will differ from every phone model. And just like before, you can zoom in and decrease opacity to make a precise shape. We will give this one a black color. Now comes the important part, the screenshot. If you're finding this tutorial useful so far, consider leaving a thumbs up and subscribing for fun tutorials like this in the future. Alright, let's now import a sample screenshot that we will be using as a guide since we cannot make a shape in PixelLab with specific dimensions. Hide all layers underneath except our reference image and place it in the right location. If your screenshot is not tall enough or it's more taller, don't pay attention to it and do not stretch your screenshot. Like Abraham Lincoln once said, stretchy images suck, don't stretch them images. Very wise words from a wise man. Anyway, so just pay attention to top, left and right. Make sure your screenshot is inside of it. Let's now create a shape and place it over our screenshot, making sure it's the same size. We will also round its edges but 2% smaller than our previous body shapes. We will delete our screenshot since we no longer need it. Select your screenshot shape, go to texture and select your screenshot. Nice. This shape will now act as our screenshot. To fix the empty space situation at the bottom, we will simply select each of our body layer and bring them up. To keep things accurate, we will bring our reference image up a bit and then make each shape smaller accordingly. Making the camera is a little bit tricky. Since there is no grouping system in PixelLab, we will have to make it as a PNG. So first, let's hide all the layers. Now create a new circle shape. Let's give it a black color so we can see it and place it in the center. Use grids and snap to grid to make sure it's in center. Duplicate it and lock the previous layer. Make it a little bit smaller and place it in the center. And let's give this one a gray color. Just like before, duplicate and lock previous layer. Make it smaller than the last circle, center it once again and give it a black color yet again. I know this is getting annoying, but we will do this one last time. Duplicate and lock the previous layer. We will make it smaller, but instead of placing it in the center, we will place it between the smaller black and gray circles. Don't make it too small though, otherwise it won't be visible. We will give this one a white color and it will act as a shine on the camera. And there we have a minimalist camera graphic. We will make our background transparent, load export image and save it as a PNG in ultra dimensions. Once saved, hit undo to bring back our background and delete all circles we've created so far. For now, we will only unhide our reference image. Tap the plus icon and select the camera graphic we made from our gallery. Scale it down and place it in the right location. You can enable guides again to center it properly. I think you got the gist of it by now. Now just hide your reference layer and unhide the rest. As a bonus and because I love you all, let me show you how you can now use this mockup in your videos with a screen recording. First, we will make our background transparent. Then select our screenshot layer and remove the texture from it. Go to Shape Edit Settings and give it a bright green color. Export this as a transparent PNG. In your video editing app such as KineMaster, all you have to do is import your PNG, chroma key the green screen from it, and place your screen recording under it. If you want to learn how to fake telephoto in your photos, click the card above or click the bottom card to learn how to make studio light effect in PixArt. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace out.